Hey, happy Friday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus, and I'm giving the latest update on what's going on with this weather pattern. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long with my weather forecasting. Matter of fact, I've been talking about this cold front coming through almost a week now, and the rainfall that is going to bring with it. Now, this isn't bringing nowhere flooding, and if you're over 20 years old, you know that this happens about every 20 years. So it's not like you've never seen it before, but it is a rare pattern. What we're going to have in sense is we're going to have the cold air coming through. We're going to have our below average temperatures, big high pressure, build a big high ridge with our trough coming through. Remember that, all the cold air coming in. I seen you in Texas talking about, hey, where's this cold air you talking about? It is coming. Not only for the cold air, you're going to be cold air below temperatures, and you're going to be above average in precipitation. So you're really going to like it over there. But still, what it is, you have this big high pressure that is building, a big high pressure of the big ridge that's going. Remember, a big high pressure goes clockwise. Then you got the big high pressure over here over the southeast, and this is all going clockwise. So what this is doing is pulling precipitation and bringing it in this direction for multiple days. About 6-7 days tops, and then it starts spreading out with some shortwave trough. It's not going to be a big NOAA flooding, but it is going to bring a lot of heavy precipitation to a lot of people that actually want it. And you can see from here, just going by the next 5 days, is bringing rainfall. It is bringing some over here towards New Mexico, Arizona, into Colorado as well, but it's going to be heavier for Texas, for Louisiana. Now, this is bringing heavier rainfall towards Mississippi, Alabama, northern Georgia, eastern Tennessee, the Carolinas and Virginia, even some of Florida. So as you have your drought monitor, you really need this rain in New Mexico. You really need it in western Texas. You also have it over here for the Carolinas and Virginia. Y'all really need this rainfall also. So as this rain starts coming in, it's going to help out with a lot of this drought that y'all do have. Now for today, we also have some severe weather as these storms come by for this afternoon. Just come by for the evening. It's not bringing chances for tornadoes. It's bringing a slight chance for winds and a slight chance for hail. Nothing super heavy. But you see, after today is going to kick right back in for tomorrow. And all these storms, you can see how it's all sporadic in nature. That's why I'm trying to tell you, it's not going to be no huge storm that's coming across just massively flooding everybody, but it is going to start adding up day by day when your ground's already soaked. Eventually, it's going to start doing some ponding on the roads. Maybe even your creeks and streams might start overfilling some. So what I'm going to do is go through this so you can see exactly what the impacts will be and what this will potentially add up to, just so you can prepare a little bit for this. You're actually going to like it. If you're on the center of the lower 48 towards the eastern side, you're going to like the temperatures that's coming. You're going to like the rainfall. It is going to bring a lot of beneficial rainfall. If you're on the western side of lower 48, you're really going to hate it because it's going to be a big high ridge of heat and no precipitation. Now for today, you can see you have those 90s in the south central going all the way up into Canada. For the southwest, you're still over 110, 115 degree heat temperatures going all the way up towards the west coast. A little bit better in the northwest, but you're still in the 90s, and you're starting to cool off on the eastern side of the lower 48. Now with your heat indices, it's still going to be a little hot for southern Texas and as you go through Florida during this time. Now for tonight, you still got the cool air coming on down. You're still going to be in the 50s and 60s overnight and the 70s across the south. But you can see this latest pattern when you look with the Euro. So you have this big high pressure of heat, a big dome over here. And you got the high pressure coming in, stretching from Atlantic into the Gulf. And this is all bringing that precipitation right in this direction. And this is what's giving you the training of storms over and over all the way into next week. Then we got that tricky wave coming through, still not showing that we're going to get anything out of that wave, just maybe some rainfall as we go towards the end of July, but showing that that pattern is going to stick around at least 6 or 7 days and maybe change after that, because this high pressure of heat is going to start moving over the center of the lower 48, and this is going to change our weather pattern. So this isn't going to be like a month-long event. This isn't going to be no 10-day event. This is going to be a little over a week potentially. Showing is going to be waves of storms. So you can see this for your precipitation with the Euro. As you go all the way through Saturday, it's going to bring some rainfall, but then it's going to start adding up again on the next storm system as we go in from Monday into next week, all the way until Wednesday and Thursday, start adding up more rainfall. But once again, this is not going to bring no super extreme flooding. This is going to drain a little bit every day, but sooner or later, it's going to start ponding on the roads, and it could bring up your streams. And maybe as you go towards 10 days, start adding more moisture that could be coming north. That I still don't believe yet. I believe the next 6 days, maybe 7 days tops, because after that, our pattern always changes and everything always updates. You never believe a 10-day precipitation forecast. It always moves, but I will keep you updated. If this sticks around, I will be very surprised. Now, you can see on the latest drought monitor, just like I showed you in the beginning, there is no exceptional drought, but we do have an extreme drought that's going for southern New Mexico, western Texas. We also have it for the northern half of Alabama, some of Mississippi, some of Tennessee, the Carolinas through Virginia. They really need the rainfall. Also up here towards the northwest, they really need it for Montana, Idaho, some of Washington also. So there is a lot of areas that really need this rainfall. And if you look for the 3 month for the seasonal drought, they're still expecting drought to persist in all this dark brown area. So even though you get this rainfall coming through, they're still expecting this drought to persist in all of this brown area. And if you look at all this light brown, this is where they're expecting drought to develop. The only drought removal likely is this dark green area for southern Georgia, northern Florida. So even though you got a lot of rainfall coming, you better enjoy it, because you do have drought expecting coming in your area right afterwards. But this is bringing a good bit of rainfall for the next 7 days. You can see this with National Weather Service showing out of Louisiana, but you can see some of Texas, you can see Mississippi as well, where they're expecting for your rainfall amount. And they're showing anywhere from 3 to 8 inches for the next 7 days. This isn't the next couple of days, next 7 days, and possibly isolated events for 10 inches that can occur also. We also can see it does bring chances to bring some flash flooding, some river and bayou flooding that could also occur. But you can also see here what was put out for Houston, Texas. So you better be ready, because I was not joking. You have below average temperatures coming in, some cooler days, while you're getting above average precipitation. So you will see the biggest difference out of everybody. Now, the temperatures are going to change. So as we go into tomorrow, you can see we still have all these 90s going all the way up into Canada. You still have the 80s over here for the eastern side of lower 48. And you still have 110 towards 115 degrees temperatures towards the southwest, going all the way towards the higher elevations in Idaho. And you can see with your heat indices, it's not really affecting much. Extreme lower Texas and lower Florida, you're still going to be in the heat indices during this time. But as you keep going, you see all the way towards Tuesday, this is where the pattern stays in that high ridge all the way into Canada, bringing these high 90s. You're still going to be in the 110 plus degrees all the way to the southwest. That has not changed, and it will remain in the 80s for everybody else. And as you keep going towards 6 days away, you can see all that extreme temperatures kicking in. Now you're getting those hundreds, 105 going all the way from Oregon, Washington into Montana, even getting over 100 into Canada now. And look at the extreme temperatures for the southwest. This is not stopping. But look over here for the center of the lower 48 and east. You are going to be on that nice cool down. These storms are going to help bring cooler temperatures as well, and that above average precipitation. Y'all really going to like it. Even though it's going to be stormy, I think you're really going to like it. And as you go towards 7 days away, you can still see that extreme ridge going into Canada with all these hot temperatures going north, also for the southwest, but you're still going to remain cool for the eastern side of the lower 48. But this is where that high ridge starts going a little further towards the east. So I just want to give you a quick update on the impacts of everything that was going on with the cold front and what was going on with the rainfall. It's been almost a week since I talked about it, and I've been seeing some crazy stories going out there like this is going to be some big significant event. And it's not. This does happen about once every 20 years when we get these high pressures colliding like this and just bringing all that precipitation in. Now you see from the latest from the ensembles, as you look with the Canadian ensemble, still showing as we go towards the end of July, going to start bringing chances for these storms to come, and still showing we have that one going towards the southeast. You can see with the GFS, it's putting it in different locations, but still showing we're going to go through that transition as we go towards the end of July. So I will keep you updated on the tropics as well. I just want to do a quick update on today, let you know what was going on with these temperatures and the rainfall. I truly believe the rainfall is a blessing. So I think I really should enjoy this rainfall. Make good use of this rainfall. Watch out for ponding on the roads. Be careful. You know how these storms can get when it rains over and over. I've seen a lot of heavy precipitation, especially for Texas and Louisiana. Be careful of that. But this is going to help with a lot of y'all farming. It's going to help with your plants. It's going to help all around with your temperatures and everything else. I think it really is a blessing, this transition you are going in. It could be some bad problems out of it, so you got to be careful with these storms as it starts adding up day by day. But you're from the South. You know what it's like with these storms. I think you can handle it just fine. So the last thing I'd like to add today is say thank you, God, for giving us this rainfall and these cooler temperatures right during a very hot part of our summer. We greatly appreciate it, especially the rainfall, because a lot of people need this rainfall really bad, especially not only the South, the Mid-Atlantic, the Carolinas, Virginia. They really need this rainfall bad, and I hope this is exactly what y'all get. It's exactly what we see so far on the measurements. So God bless you all. May you all get exactly what you need for your land. Hope you all have a very great weekend this weekend. I will see you again on Sunday. And remember, this is a blessing from God. This is not something to be worried about. This is not something to be super scared about. You really should enjoy this transition. Before you go, Deuteronomy 28, 12 and 13. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven to give the rain unto thy land in his season, and to bless all the work of thine hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. And the Lord shall make thee the head, and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If that thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day, to observe and to do them. Amen. Pray to our Father, Yahweh in heaven. Thank our Father. Always give thanks for everything. Even when bad things happen in your life, you don't know why they're happening, but they're all working for his good. And later on, you find out that you was actually saved from something that could have been even worse. Give thanks to our Father. He works all the time, and he's trying to bless you with this rain. Enjoy this rainfall. You really need it. But always give thanks. Remember, all glory always goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and everyone around you and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Make sure you help somebody today.